All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is James Sykes. He is the CEO of Metal Energy Corp. And James, good to see you again. How are you?
Steve, I'm doing awesome, especially with the results that we have.
Yeah, so more great results talking about identifying two brine reservoirs. So I'll let you take us into sort of the work that led to this. Obviously, there was some downhole work that was done.
Yeah, so very simply put, we did a diamond drill program and we've sampled for assays, but more specifically, we were interested in the brines in the sedimentary formations. So we did some downhole surveying, we did some downhole geophysics and downhole packer testing to sample the waters, and using the geophysical surveys to identify which were the most conductive brine intervals or reservoirs allowed us to better discretely sample the fluids from those intervals.
Yeah. How far down are we talking about here, James?
The hole terminated at about 547 meters. So the two sedimentary horizons occur between 150 and 165 and then meters below surface, and then as well between 475 and 520 meters beneath the surface. Not too
so deep. So when you say you were able to encounter the liquid, maybe you can sort of explain that so people understand. What exactly are you looking for? Like what type of liquid is it?
It's brine. So brine is basically just salty water. And okay. We know that we have extremely salty water just based on the conductivities that we've been seeing from downhole geophysics. Now, typically in a brine solution, you've got sodium, magnesium, calcium, potassium, and lithium to varying degrees. And typically the higher concentrations and all of those elements are called total dissolved solids. Typically the higher total dissolved solids that you have in your brine, the higher the lithium concentration. It seems to be a one-to-one ratio that we've seen from other scientific research. And we're hoping the same plays out true for our SourceRock project.
So where do you go from here now? What's the next stages of this?
Wait for the water sample results. That's what we're after. That's what we're waiting on. Once we get those back, then we'll plan accordingly. We think there's a lot of potential in this project. We're not just sampling for lithium. We're sampling for a whole suite of elements, including rare earth elements in water. A lot of people probably don't know that Canada's legitimate first rare earth operation was from a brine scenario in Elliott Lake. So we think that there could be free floating rare earth elements in these brines as well. And yeah, we don't want to let anything pass us by.
Absolutely. All right. We'll wait to see the results there. James, thank you so much. Good update. And I guess we'll be talking very soon again. Thank you.
We'll have results to talk about shortly. Yes. Thanks, Steve. Take care.
All right. Good stuff. James Sykes, the CEO of Metals Energy Corp.